So, you know, I was thinking about what I was going to talk about because I just didn't want this to be just, you know, a lecture where we spoke about things that you're like, okay, sounds nice right now. And then after you get out of the thing, you're like, okay, forget it. Because I wasn't taught like that. I was taught that things that you can do on a day-to-day basis, which really change the game. So I was thinking, I was like, okay, what do I talk to them about? I said, okay, all the big business leaders meditate. That's a good sign. Jack Dorsey does Vipassana. There's Bill Gates, who also meditates 3 times a week. There is Steve Jobs, who used to really, really meditate as well. He used to do Zen. Someone or the other did something which would help them deal with whatever they were going to be. Now, it's always a choice what you want to be in life. You know, dealt with people who've been negative and in turn have complained about them many, many times. And then after a while, you're like, okay, I just keep focusing on this one person again and again. I don't feel good about it, right? Or, you know, you meet some people who are like relentlessly optimistic. You feel so good sitting next to them. So the way that it was explained to me, and I'm going to try and explain this to you, was it boils down to energy. Okay? So pranic healing comes from the word prana, which is Sanskrit for energy. So if you've heard about Aikido, if you've heard about Tai Chi, Reiki, so Ki and Chi are different terms for energy, and everybody has it. Okay? Without energy, the body doesn't survive. So when somebody dies, they say, uske pran chhut gaye. Right? So what happens is your life force helps you out in everything. The greater the life force, and all the big business leaders, by the way, have massive energy levels. Someone who is, let's say, young or, you know, not done very much in their life, they have an average aura or an energy body. But someone who wants to be great, okay, their energy levels, their aura is much bigger than normal. It's like a couple of feet, whereas someone on the road would have an energy level of about 3 to 4 inches. Now, whatever you do affects your energy body. The way that you think, the way that you speak, your words have energy, your thoughts have energy. All right? So, your body replenishes itself every night. It's like a living battery. Every night when you sleep, it replenishes itself to deal with the day ahead. Your body also can heal itself. Right? So if you cut yourself, what happens? It's even if you don't put a bandage, it's able to heal. Right? So how do you accelerate this? How do you accelerate not only your healing, physically, emotionally, mentally, but how do you become really great at what you do? I remember when I was, and she referred it, she brought it up, but when I was broken, my spine was broken in 2 places. I, for the first time in my life, saw what it was like to be helpless. And when I got out of it, and I met many, many people at that point, I met many doctors who weren't exactly very compassionate at that point. They said, okay, you can't walk. So for someone who's 21 at that point, it's horrifying. So, you know, you get up and you see many, many instances where you grow up and you're like, status quo cannot remain. How people thought 10 years ago, how I think now, has to change, right? The biggest problem is we make the same mistakes again and again and again. We're in a loop. And you're like, why did this happen to me? Why did this happen to me? So when I asked my teacher about that, I said, you know, I seem to be making the same mistakes again. How does one deal with it? And I asked him this and he goes, just be aware. And I said, what do you mean by, you know, just be aware? I couldn't understand what, I'm sure most of you are like, what does she mean? How do you be aware? Okay, it's something like this. Every day, you stop for about, before you sleep, or when you first wake up, you go through your day. You're lucky you're in such a beautiful area where the sources of prana, the energy are so high. Okay, you need to think about what you're saying, what you're scrolling, how your comments are. You know, firstly, it just means watch what you think, watch what you say, watch what you post. Right? Because it shows a certain type of energy. And I was laughing because someone I know the other day was on Bumble. Okay? Some of you know what I'm talking about. Some of you are like, what? But basically, and every time she saw someone, she would criticize the person. Criticize. terrible, right? You know what I'm talking about. So, I said, you know, for a second, even if you don't like the person, why don't you think about one good thing that you can think about this person? Okay? So, it became an exercise in trying to see now how the energy changes. Okay? After about 15 going over that, it was super nice. You could immediately feel the change in yourself. Because you see, every time you criticize someone, it has an effect on your energy body. It has an effect on your chakras. So if you keep criticizing, you may be right in what you're saying, but it is not compassionate. And it affects your body. It affects your energy. You don't want to be that person who nobody wants to sit next to. You know what I mean? When you walk into a room, and there's some people who are so nice. They don't have to say anything. You just like being around them, right? And there's some people who you can't stand. So again, it's a choice. What do you want to be? How do you want your energy to be? How does one even deal with energy, right? So, would you like to feel energy? Yeah? Okay. So you'll have to follow me.
When you were, okay, was it easier when you kept saying good words? Was the energy increasing and was it becoming denser? Like it was easier to pick up on? Yes? Alright. When you were saying that I'm angry, I'm horrible, what started happening to the energy?
It started dissipating.
Exactly. It started dissipating. It started becoming smaller. So what you say, what you do, even if you don't mean it a lot of the times, it becomes a habit, right? This person said something to me, this person's rude to me, always I'm going to just... You see, what you meditate on will become. So you have to figure out a way to get yourself out of this loop, okay? And how we do it is with energy, at least in our school. Okay, so it's like, okay, you learn how to cleanse. And so I used to teach the police. Eva hasn't mentioned that part where she used to assist me in writing. We used to have this huge wall of policemen who, at the first time when they used to walk in, they used to, you know how they are, right? Sitting in the way of
police.
This is
scary.
So, all of them. Okay, so we used to handle that. They used to actually be very good students. And after the class, they used to be shining and they used to be super happy. Now, if those guys can suddenly be like all shiny and happy, I'm sure we can manage that, right?
Certainly.
Okay, so I don't know if you know about this, but for the ones who are interested in knowing more, we actually have a meditation which is 21 minutes planned, and if you'd like to feel that and also use the energy to really direct it, well, let me think about it. We can do something for, you know, our lives, our families, our wishes, what do you want in this year? You see, you have to set your goals, right? This is the beginning of the year. You have to decide what is it that you want. What happens to a flight which does not have a destination? It keeps revolving, you eventually crash, run out of fuel. That's the same thing with life. You have to know where you're going. It's not very nice saying, okay, someone else will look after it, but you have to. So for the next 2 minutes, I want you to think exactly on what you want, and then if you are ready, we can do the meditation here. I don't think they will fit in that room anyway, in the wellness room. So what we can do is do a very, very simple, quick meditation called the meditation on the enhancement. It's got to do with a lot of inner peace, a lot of love. And during the pandemic, actually, we've done thousands and thousands and lakhs of people have been coming in virtually and doing it every day at 6 p.m. So we've been handling that and with The changes have been incredible. Most people meditate, but you have to understand, you have to find the right meditation for yourself. It's like school. What is it that you want? You walk into school, you go to have different subjects. So Vipassana will do something, Twin Hearts will do something, Raja Yoga, they all have different uses, okay? This one specifically is for love and for peace and to remove negative thoughts and emotions. So I think most of us would do with the shock of that, right? You can't buy love, you can't buy peace, you know? However rich you are, that's something you can't go out and buy. You know what, it's like yesterday I was doing this meditation on Tuesday, and for some reason, everybody was writing, but I broke up during this whole pandemic. I had this problem. I'm like, oh God, this turned out to be... I was like, okay. Who do I get married to? All of that. So I was laughing. I said, marriage is something like, you know, a besieged fort. Everybody who's inside wants to get out. Everyone who's outside wants to get in. Can you think about something negative right now or something that brings you down? Or is it difficult to do so? It's difficult, right? So that's how you use energy to help you become what you want. It's in your hands. It's not based on how you look, or it's not based on, you know, somebody. Yes, those are external factors, but the internal factors are the ones that matter the most. It's you. You have to be really secure in who you are. All right? So thank you very much for your time.